What's up, guys? Goodwill Hunter here again. Back at the Team Amvet thrift store where I continue to never find shit but keep going. Let's see if my luck's gonna change for once. Team Amvet was a bust again, which I figured it would be, but at least I had a little bit extra time to look around, leaving to go to work a little bit earlier today. So yeah, I'm going to check out the Goodwill over here in Rosecrans again, and sometimes I get some good luck over here. I found some good stuff in here. About a month ago, I picked up Super Mario 64 for $5.99. It's a $25 game, so that was a pretty good find. But, yeah, hoping to score something like that again inside here. So, let's go inside and take a look. Donkey Kong.
Me want games.
But not those ones.
Alright, so I did find something inside the Goodwill over here. Nothing spectacular or anything, but got a PS1 game, NBA Live 2000. My nigga. With Michael Jordan. Paid $2.99. It's worth about $5, so not too bad. It was definitely a keeper. Eh, you know, it wasn't a waste of time. Alright, I'm going to do one more stop just around the corner from where I just left the Goodwill. It's the Salvation Army. Take a look in here real quick. I got about 10 minutes before I got to start heading to work.
Flash! He saved every one of us. Except for these sport games. Nobody wants these. Or the dancing ones. These all suck. And nobody buys them. That's kind of cool. Seeing PlayStation 3 games in here now. I think I have this one already on the GameCube, so pass on that one. 2K5, already got that one for the PS2. Tiger Woods, y'all. Game Day Football. Yeah, all shit I don't want to need.
Okay, well, I'm off to work now. I was in there for about a good 10 minutes. They had a shitload of brand new CDs in there that I was weeding through, but not one freaking PlayStation game. So, but I did find, you know, a sport game for the PS2. I'm a big sucker for the baseball games. I love playing those kind of games. So I did pick up High Heat Major League Baseball 2002. By 3DO. It's worth about $5. I paid $3. So not too bad. But yeah, off to work now. I gotta work so I can pay my bills. So see you guys later. What's up, guys? Goodwill Hunter here. I'm over at the Kobe Swap Meet today, getting ready to, you know, see if I can find anything today. It's a little late for Friday. It's already slow as it is, but I'm just gonna walk around, take a look anyways, and get some video with the spyglasses here. Okay, so apparently I'm not going to get any footage with these glasses because the batteries are dead.
How much for this?
Amor, ¿cuánto el este?
$4. $4? Okay, thanks. Mm-hmm. How much for this one?
$3.
$3?
Yeah.
Try to be best, cause you're only a man, and a man's got to learn to take it. Try to believe, though the going gets rough, that you got a hand tough to make it. History repeats itself, try and you succeed. Never doubt that you're the one.
Well, that was a quick walk through the swap meet. I did get a couple PS1 games and a movie. But yeah, I was really slow in there. So, there's always tomorrow. I just walked out of Goodwill over here in Rosecrans and found a couple more PS1 games. I'll show you one of them. Pretty nice one.
My nigga.
Not bad for $2.99.
What's up, guys? Goodwill Hunter here. It is April 21st. Hope everybody had a great Easter OK Chief 420 holiday yesterday. In case you guys don't know, this episode is brought to you by AMPM. Oh, yeah. Too much good stuff. Now let's go hunting. We are back over here in Poway, over at my favorite spot. Got my spy cam glasses on today.
Let's see what they got up in there.
There's the Turok Rage Wars and the Gemini one. Might go with this one. Set that aside for me. Thanks.
Here at the power pond, see if they got anything new.
Yeah, I come into this place probably about once a week. A couple weeks ago, I actually picked up 4 Wii games for $40 and got a pretty good deal. But usually I see pretty much the same stuff every time I go in here, but every now and then they got some new stuff. But that's the same old stack of Wii games. Not really interested in any of those. And those NES games, I've already picked through all the ones that he had available that I didn't need. He's really not doing any more retro games, so those are the ones that are left over that I didn't pick up. And all these DS game, Game Boy Advance games over here, he's offered me any of those games for $5 each, which I'm sure most go for about $3 to $5, but not really into those.
Yeah, so it was pretty much the same stuff from before. There was a couple Wii games in there. I wouldn't mind getting, like, Tenchu and one other one. But I'm not really feeling like spending any money on Wii games lately because I'm not really playing the Wii that much anymore. So I'm going to check out the other thrift stores around here. Let's see what they got.
Just walked through a couple more thrift stores in the Poway area and didn't really find anything great, didn't find much at all, but I did come across a CD section in one of the stores and I found a couple PS1 games that were sitting next to a sign that was marked 50 cents for each PC game, and I did notice they had some PlayStation games up front and they were asking $4 each, which is ridiculous for PS1 games, especially when they're all sports titles. But I did find a couple over in the other section, and when the lady asked me, you know, if these were music CDs or whatnot, she saw that they were games, and I was like, yeah, I found them over there at that other section. And so she's like, oh, those are the PC games. She said, okay, so those are 50 cents, half off. That's going to be 25 cents each. I'm like, all right, that's cool. And so I picked up a couple sports games, but love baseball. I got a triple play 2001. And then I also picked up MLB 98. So, not bad. 25 cents each. I'll take it. What's up, guys? I'm over here in Rancho Bernardo area. I'm going to go check out this Goodwill that I went to a couple weeks ago where I found that JVCI. Who knows? Maybe they got my TurboGrafx sitting in there waiting for me to pick up. So let's check them out. We're here. Goodwill here. Not having much luck today finding anything, so I'm over here in Kern Mesa right now. You know, walking to the book off store with my spy cane glasses. So let's go on inside.
$60. $100 for Super Nintendo. Wow. Jaguar.
They're waiting for you.
Okay guys, that's about all I got footage-wise for the week. But let's go over up to Riverside and take a look at the other Goodwill Phil.
Hey guys, the other Goodwill Phil here. I spent a couple days out hunting this week. Found some pretty good stuff, so we're going to take a look at that footage. And after that, come back, sit down, and I'll go over what I found. Alright, so the first stop was at the good old Van Buren swap meet. It's a pretty big swap meet, even in the middle of the week. It's always treated me pretty well. The first find was this Mortal Kombat game for PS2. It was real clean. Guy wanted $5 for it, which is a little on the pricey side, but I'm a big Mortal Kombat fan, so I didn't mind for $5. He also had a PS2 sitting there. He wanted $45 for it. Way too much. The next vendor, I ended up picking up Kung Fu Panda and Sonic game. $2 each. Didn't see many NES games out this week, but these two weren't worth anything. Then I found this guy. He wanted $3 a piece for his games, or $2 for $5. And they were all really clean, good shape, complete. So I ended up picking up Jack 2, Carmen Sandiego, The Hobbit, and Crazy Taxi. All four of them for only $10. This vendor, she wanted $8 a piece for the Nintendo 64 and the Super NES games. There wasn't anything there that was worth that much. This guy had this big old box of games and he only wanted 75 cents a piece. Bunch of them were complete and in really good shape. I ended up picking up 7 of them, and I'm kind of kicking myself because I probably should have bought more. There's some others that I probably could have made some money off of, and there's a bunch of Atari games sitting right next to the box that he only wanted 75 cents for a piece as well, and I was so excited about the PS2 games, I didn't even pay attention to those Atari games. Thank you. I do have a hard time walking by a stack of comic books. These were all faded, so I passed. Saw this Sega Dreamcast over here. It wasn't in the greatest shape, pretty dirty, and the controllers were kind of beat up, so I passed. Alright, so that does it for the swap meet. I got 7 games, PS2s, in really great shape for 75 cents a piece. $5.25 for 7 games. Pretty happy with that. A couple other games that I might overpay a little bit, but I think they got some pretty good value. I ended up picking up a total of 16 games, and I spent $41. And so that averages out to around two and a half bucks a game. 14 are PS2s, 2 of them are Game Boy Advance, and I think all the discs are perfect, no scratches. I didn't pick up anything with a scratch on it, and they're all complete. Every single game I picked up is complete. All in all, a good time at the swap meet. I'm going to head over to Savers and then check out a couple other thrift stores now. So we'll see if the luck continues. All right, so this is the Savers in Riverside off of Tyler. I've never had any luck here. I've had great luck at the Savers in Murrieta. But I got my fingers crossed, and I'm going to hopefully score something good here one of these days. So every time I go to the swap meet, it makes no sense not to drive to the very next exit on the freeway and check this place out. So at the Riverside Savers, just like Murrieta, I walk in and head to the left. In Riverside, it's usually just CDs up on the shelf here, but in Murrieta, they have games and all kinds of stuff in this area. So I still look through the CDs to see if there's any PS1 games or anything good hidden in here. Then up by the front counter, they have all their PS2 games and Xbox games, if they have any. Usually not a very great selection at this Savers. After that, I went to a couple different Salvation Armies, and I drove through some new territory over in the city of Lake Elsinore. Hit up a few thrift stores over there. I didn't find anything at all. The rest of the day was just a dud, so I'm glad I had a nice score at the swap meet. Just a few hours ago, I was out dumpster diving. It's like 8 in the morning, heading to swap meet. It hurts. But gotta stick to my game. Gotta get my Goodwill hunting on. So up here at the Beaumont swap meet, I found a guy who always has 50 cent games. There was a reason for it today. None of them were in good shape, or they were sports games that nobody wanted. So I ended up passing on all those. Another vendor, a bunch of games, but nothing really worth anything. This guy had a bunch of nice stuff, but reseller prices. He wanted way too much. He did have a Game Boy Advance and a case for a Game Boy Advance. It was pretty neat looking, but I don't even remember what he wanted. Just way too much. Then over here, this guy didn't have too much in the way of games, but he did have this Incredibles in the wrapper still sitting there.
There's obviously not much going on here today, but I did get one score, so I'm very happy I showed up. Anytime I can get a brand new game in the box, sealed for $5, not bad. Maybe not the greatest game in the world, but when it's still sealed and brand new, should be love getting my hands on that.
Alright, so that's what went on up here this week. Do a little recap real quick, try and make it short and sweet. Got a bunch of games from Goodwill Phil down south, stuff that he had, duplicates, doubles of, or things that he just didn't want anymore. Sent 16 PS2 games my way, so appreciate you. Speaking of PS2 games, I was at the swap meet, and there was a guy selling PS2 games for 75 cents a piece. Now, I bought a bunch of stuff this week, so I don't remember exactly which ones. Probably saw in the video, but if not, which I don't know what I put in there, I don't remember. But anyways, I'm going to go over what I got. But everything I bought was clean, no scratches, and complete this week. I wasn't buying anything that wasn't in really good shape. So quickly, I've got this Crazy Taxi game. Looks really fun. Kung Fu Panda, which looks okay. The value just doesn't seem to be there. But Splinter Cell, not a big value either. This Mortal Kombat, I ended up paying $5 for this, but I'm a big Mortal Kombat fan. Lord of the Rings, The Hobbit, Sonic Mega Collection, can't go wrong with Sonic. This one, just because it was cheap, World Championship Poker. This one looks a lot of fun, haven't played it yet, Carmen Sandiego. Surprisingly, this NHRA game looks like it probably worth maybe $6 to $8. I didn't think it had much value, but it sold for some good money so far, so we'll see. Triple Play 02, Red Faction, this is Jack 2, and Medal of Honor. And the best I did this week was picked up this Dark Cloud, which I think I'm gonna switch the box out. I got a little rip in the corner here of the case, but the game, the booklet, and everything is in great shape. Paid $5 for this. Should be able to get close to $15 out of it. So this $10 profit right there. Picked up a few Xbox games just because the price was right. And it looks like I could probably make at least a couple bucks each off of them. Not a big Xbox collector, so typically anytime I buy these, it's just to move them. So 007, Agent Under Fire, Aragon, I guess that one I'm going to have a tough time making any money on. But Return to Castle Wolfenstein, that one I should be able to make a few bucks. Halo, Combat Evolved, Halo 2, $4 a piece for those. They're going to make me some money. Need for Speed, Hot Pursuit 2. Not really sure what that's worth yet. But here comes the exciting stuff. Swap meet this morning, I picked up only one game, and it just happened to be The Incredibles for PS2. Paid $5 for it, but it is complete, if you can see that. It is still sealed in the package. Got the little sticker on it and all that. So, brand new game for $5. Looks like I should be able to get about $15 for it. But being brand new, I might just stick it on the shelf. We'll see. Over at the Goodwill, I picked up Super Mario Brothers Duck Hunt. It was $5. so I don't think I can make any money off it, but I didn't get it for that. I got it to actually kind of start up my NES collection. Goodwill Phil down in San Diego has one heck of a collection. His is pretty huge and got me a little jealous, so I'm going to start up mine, and I've got a Nintendo for sale right now, FYI, if anybody wants it. Check out our eBay page, but complete in a box. That one I'm trying to make a little money off of, so I'm going to pick myself up NES that's not complete, something that I can play with and won't worry about damaging. So anyways, $5. The other game that I got over there was Gradius, and that looks pretty fun. And if I can't get the money out of it that I want off of eBay, I'm going to hold on to it. But I think I'm going to need probably like $12 plus a couple dollars shipping, or else I'm just going to hold on to it. Then, the big score of the week for me was over at the Salvation Army. I must have walked in at the right time, because somebody dropped off a group of 11 Atari 5600 games.
Oops, I did it again.
I paid a dollar a piece for these. And my price is out here. Starting with Congo Bongo, I'm going to ask $5.99 plus a couple dollars shipping on that. Robotron 2084, I'm going to ask $10 and throw free shipping in there. Pole Position, probably just $2 and $2 shipping. Mario Brothers, gonna ask $10.99 plus free shipping on that one. Star Trek, I'm gonna put $8 of free shipping. Kangaroo, which did I say kangaroo? I don't think I said kangaroo, but if I didn't, Kangaroo is $2 and probably a couple bucks shipping, so $4 out of it. I got Pac-Man, which I'm gonna try and get $4 and a couple dollars shipping. And then we're getting to the money makers here, the real money makers. This Decathlon, it's been selling for around $9-$10, but the cheapest you can find on eBay right now is $38. So I'll probably price it somewhere in between, but it doesn't even look like that great of a game, but it's just rare. So yeah, that right there. Hopefully I'll see at least maybe $15 out of that, but I'm gonna probably start the auction around $10. Then got this Hero game. Hero, the cheapest you can find on eBay right now is $24, and all these prices are loose. I didn't get any boxes, so all the prices I confirmed with loose. I didn't look compared to, you know, complete boxes. Or complete games. But yeah, the Hero, $24 is the cheapest you can find it right now. I think I'll start the auction at $21 with free shipping. We'll see how it goes. Then I got this Gyrus, and this one right now, it's going for, people are asking about $17 or so, right? It's a lot of action right around the $17 mark. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to look for $17 out of that. And then the best of all the best is this Frogger 2 3 Deep. Cheapest you can find this on eBay right now is like $78. And I'm going to start my auction probably, I think at like $45.99 or something, and see what I can get out of that. But based on if I get what I want on the games, that I'm going to have a buy it now, and the others with the auctions, even if I get minimum bid, that's over $135, about $140 almost, for just these 11 games that I paid $11 for. So I'm going to be up in the neighborhood of $125 for those games. So big score there. The rest of my stuff, I spent about $40, and I should have somewhere in the neighborhood of $65 or so. So I'm up $25. But that doesn't count the Incredibles game. So profit this week somewhere in the area of a $180, $190 profit. So it was a really good week for me, which beats the heck out of last week because I think I had like a $5 profit or something. I mean, it was a joke. I only got a couple games. So a little more time invested in hunting and a lot better results. So it pays to be out there. It pays to be looking. Speaking of being out there and looking, Goodwill Phil and I have been doing some dumpster diving. We got a new series that we just started. Episode 1 was out. We've got some great response on it. People are liking it. A couple clowns giving us a hard time, but that's typical, I guess. We've already taped another episode that we're working on editing and getting up for you guys, so keep an eye out for that. It's going to be fun. It's good stuff. We really have come up on some pretty neat stuff and some frustrating moments as well. Keep an eye out for that, and that's about all I've got up here. So I'm going to send it back down to Goodwill Phil down in San Diego. Take it easy.
Okay, for this week, a couple of NES games. I picked up Burger Time. And Spy Hunter. My nigga. Pac-Man Tengen. My nigga. And the Fighting Machine Zeronia or something like that. My nigga. And then for the N64, I picked up Turok, the original Turok. My nigga. And then for the Sega Genesis, I picked up one of my favorite games, Super Street Fighter 2. My nigga. The Revenge of Shinobi. My nigga. And for the PS1s, I got The Fifth Element. My nigga. Some Tenchu. My nigga. Part 2. Midway's Arcade. Arcade's Greatest Hits. My nigga. Ridge Racer 4. My nigga. My nigga. I got Tokyo Highway Battle. My nigga. Eagle One Harrier Attack. My nigga. Got some RC Revenge. My nigga. And for the PS2, I picked up Technic Beat. My nigga. Dark Cloud. My nigga. And that's pretty much all I got for the week. Not really finding much luck out there, but still trying. So, as always, if you like what you saw, please give it a thumbs up. And if you didn't, fuck it, thumbs down it. And but if you do like it, subscribe. And as always, I'm the Goodwill Hunter, and I'll see you guys next week.